Madge Bellamy's film career started out to be the bee's knees. She was born in Hillsborough, Texas, and she started her performing career at age 9 as a dancer in Aida. In the year 1919, she married a gentleman named Carlos Bellamy. They divorced shortly thereafter, and her agent said keep the name because back then divorce was a scandal. Madge Bellamy, though, sounds a lot better than Margaret Durden Philpott, right? Now, also in 1919, her career took a skyrocket when she replaced, on stage, America's first lady of theater, Helen Hayes. In 1920, she signed her first film contract. Her breakout role was the 1922 picture, Lorna Doone, in which she played the title role. The reviews were favorable. They said things such as, the exquisite Madge, the most beautiful girl in America. Tennis, anyone? In 1924, she signed with Fox Studios. While at Fox, she made two John Ford pictures, Iron Horse and Lightning. But things then began to quickly go downhill for Madge Bellamy. First off, she turned down a role in the picture Ben-Hur. She wanted to play Pretty Flapper Girls, of course. And then in 1927, she lost out on the title role in the film Seventh Heaven, possibly because she was having an affair with the studio exec. That role went to Ms. Janet Gaynor, and she won the Oscar for Best Actress, the first Academy ever. In 1927, she did her first talkie, which was a partial talkie, in a film called Mother Knows Best, alongside Louise Dresser. 2 years later, in 1929, she was labeled as Miss Firecracker. Very difficult. In fact, she walked out of her contract at Fox because she wanted more money. She said, quote, I got too big for my britches. I wanted too much money, and when it was not forthcoming, I quit. In 1932, she played opposite Bela Lugosi in the motion picture White Zombie, directed by Victor Halperin. Critics panned her performance. This caused her to lose the lead in Halperin's next film, Supernatural. That role went to Miss Carol Lombard. By 1940, her film career was pretty much done. Scandal still is hitting Madge Bellamy because in 1942 she found out that her ex-boyfriend, who was quite the wealthy gentleman, was dating a model up in San Francisco. She was angry, so she drove up to San Francisco and shot at him 3 times. When she was arrested, they asked her why she shot him, and she said, I only winged him, which is what I meant to do. Believe me, I'm a crack shot. Strangely enough, Madge Bellamy only had to serve 1 year, but she got off with good behavior with only 6 months. Can you believe it? What a panic, Madge Bellamy. This is Todd Pickering for Walk of Fame Wednesdays. I will see you next week in Hollywood.